I'm going to be talking about artificial intelligence and ethics today. I had a lot of fun doing this research. Unfortunately, it was super information dense, so you have to bear with me. I'm going to try and gloss over some things. The advancement of artificial intelligence is necessary for us to further our understanding of ourselves, the natural world around us, as well as the eventual evolution of our species, regardless of any of the ethical concerns that are out there right now. Does anybody know this guy, Alan Turing? You probably do. Alan Turing was born in 1912. Quick history, he was a mathematician and a physicist, and he was instrumental in World War II in cracking a lot of codes to find where the Germans were going to attack day in and day out. He ended up making a mechanical computer, pretty much the first ever computer. Basically what it did is it would do its own operations on these codes 24/7, and it would spit out the right code at the end of the day. The next morning, people from the UK, the Allied forces, all of them would know where the Germans are going to be, and that was instrumental in us winning World War II. More importantly, though, he invented something called the idea of the Turing test. The Turing test is a social test of questions that you can give a robot, chatbot, cyborg, whatever it might be, and if the human who is interviewing that entity can't tell if it's a human or not, then it is an official artificial intelligence. So he invented that test. Now, how do you create an artificial intelligence? Well, the difference between a computer and a brain is a computer is very good at doing one thing over and over and over and over and over and not necessarily recognizing any patterns. So number crunching, essentially. Humans are really good at recognizing patterns. So this is a basic heat map of neurons in the brain. We're really complex and super efficient. Computers are efficient in very specific ways. And this is a way that we can try and replicate what a human brain might be. So when I say the word fox, you guys as humans will think of a fox, of course, but you're also gonna think of a mammal, you might think of the color orange, you might think of attitude or something, I don't know. Computer, for example, if you type in Google fox, it's only gonna give you a fox. It's not gonna have a relation to fox. So what this does, essentially, I don't know the math or any of that kind of stuff, I've read up on it briefly, but essentially what this does is if the X is fox, then everything that comes out of it would be fox, and then let's say mammal, let's say this one here might be attitude or something, and then what this computer will do is it will kind of narrow it down, much like Google sort of does now, and it will give you the result that you're looking for. And artificial intelligence will do this, but there's millions of these, and those are essentially neurons. The importance of doing this is threefold, and I think the first one is climate change. It's one of the biggest issues that we have right now. I've obviously talked about it before in the Climate Change Club and all that kind of stuff, but artificial intelligence in a computer form is nice because it can operate 24/7, 365. So it's not necessarily inherently smarter than a human might be, but it's very efficient because it never has to stop in terms of solving these problems. So it can help solve these bigger problems like global warming, poverty. The idea that we have third, second, and first world countries in 2018 with the resources we have is kind of mind-blowing to me. And artificial intelligence would be able to figure out ways, thousands of ways, where we could essentially help the world very quickly. The last is war. War, I think, can be caused by artificial intelligence, and you've probably seen a few articles out there, kind of doomsday scenarios of if we're attacked by an artificial intelligence or something like that. But the opposite is true. Defenses with artificial intelligence, from security, networking, all sorts of things can be applied with an artificial intelligence, regardless of those ethical concerns that go along with it. Finally, probably the most exciting is the evolution that we have of ourselves as a species. I would love to be a cyborg eventually, have augmented limbs and all sorts of stuff. We're halfway there right now. I saw a girl at the hospital a couple weeks ago. She had an Iron Man 3D printed arm, which I thought was super cool, and she could grip stuff. Artificial intelligence will allow us to have the technology to combine with us as a biological being. And that would be the quintessential evolution of our species. Going to Mars is cool, exploring our galaxy is cool, but I think this is probably the coolest thing that I'm looking forward to with this stuff. I'd like to end on a quote of one of my favorite astronomers, Carl Sagan. You guys probably know him. He did one of the old movie series or TV series called Cosmos. He kind of sparked learning in science. But his quote, essentially, what he's saying here with the cosmos is within us is, we're all made out of atoms. We are the universe, essentially. And we've gotten smart enough to the point that we can create something that will understand where we came from and what the universe is as a whole. So, yeah. That's it.